Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome our next speaker, Mr. Chittaranjan Mohanty, Executive Director, JP Morgan Chase & Co. Sir, may I request you to please come on the stage.
May we now call upon Ms. Nidhi Singh, Student Manager, Balaji Institute of International Business, to introduce our guest of honor.
Good morning, one and all. I, Nidhi Singh, Student Manager, BIIB, feel honored to introduce amongst you all Mr. Chittaranjan Mohanty, Executive Director, JP Morgan Chase. Sir has done his MBA from Xavier Institute of Management, Bhubaneswar. Sir comes with a varied background of institutions like NDA, National Defence Academy, and IIT Roorkee. Sir has 18 years of experience in which he worked in various organizations such as Head of Quality Insurance and Healthcare Verticals, WNS Global Services, Lean and Six Sigma Leader, GE Capital, Project Director, Planet Works, Consultant, Sales and Marketing in Polaris Software Lab Limited. Sir is a certified Master Black Belt in Six Sigma. In short, an interesting journey from lining up of being a fighter pilot, NDA Navy, to remote sensing and earth sciences, to sales, to startup, to Six Sigma, to consulting, to strategy, to one of the biggest banks in the world. Sir, we are delighted to have you amongst us. Kindly enlighten us with the words of your wisdom. Thank you.
Audible? Okay, how are we doing? I saw some people doing all those, a little bit of circulation going on, right? And I really appreciate Dr. Padi for inviting me. I'm honored, humbled, and the guest, chief guest who spoke before me, I wanted to show him the piece of paper which had 9 points and which one of your friends has printed and how much it is matching with all that he told, some of them verbatim, okay? Does not mean that great minds think alike, it is that we are from the same era. Okay, now as we go ahead, okay, you all can be as free as possible, okay? If somebody wants to stand, you can stand, okay? You can shout, but unless it's disturbing me, it's okay. But relax, okay? I don't want to do a sermony. So what would you like to hear? Would you like to hear a speech? I think you all, it's written on your face. You've heard speech so much, right? And Dr. Padi 3 times. So you are being more relaxed with us and more, what should I say? Forgiving to us, right? Okay, let's do this. Let's have a small theory done here, okay? So I propose a statement and I'd request all of you to tell me whether you're agreeing to that or not. Fair? Cool, all right. So the statement is that all of you, okay, all of you students, you are more intelligent than me. Very good. I got yes sir, no sir, maybe sir. That happens in parliament also. Okay, all right. Yes sir. Don't say I, that happens in parliament. Just raise your hand. This happens in corporate. Cool. Okay. Should I assume rest are saying no, or should I assume that there is a lot of maybe in between? Maybe. Okay. Okay. Now let me qualify the statement. I am dead sure that all of you are more intelligent than me. Now the maybe should move. Agree, not agree? Not agree. Okay. All right. Okay. So it's not a, I mean, like a big thing. It's not a Chittaranjan Mohanty theory or something. Okay. It's a very simple thing of evolution. My forefathers were monkeys. Yeah. I know some smiling, but theirs were also. Right. But assuming that all of you are younger than me, okay, and we still believe that Charles Darwin's theory of evolution, I am more monkeyer than you, and you are more human than me. Agreed? So, your brain is more developed than me by that delta X. Correct? So, which means, I again repeat my statement, all of you are more intelligent than me. Okay, now I heard more yes. Okay. No, the truth is, and I'm not telling it for the sake of it, the truth is all of you are more intelligent than me. And that's the reality. And that's the reality which each one of us has to accept with humility. When you see your nephew, niece, or somebody and get wowed, oh my God, he or she is able to do this, which I was not able to do. He or she is able to get so much of information. I didn't know. Like for us to figure out Pokemon Go, it takes time. For you guys, it is like this. Right? So, first, I believe, and believe it or not, I believe you all are more intelligent than me. I can say for myself, because I have done my theory of evolution, and I'm nowhere. I am the monkey. Now, if you all are more intelligent than me, then an intelligent question for you. Why are you listening to me? Wow. You are taught well. Okay, so, very good. I would just put another word before the experience, relevant experience. Okay, and if you were to look at an XY axis, okay, and you have to put the coordinates on one axis, intelligence, on another axis, relevant experience, and you get an area, and if you still remember some of your calculus, the area under the curve is the intellect. And hopefully we all being human beings respect and listen to intellect, which means some of you could be so super intelligent that your one axis takes you so forward with little relevant experience also, I would listen to you. Do you agree to this theory? Are you all with me? So that's the paradigm shift today. That day one, day two, day zero, or my 20th year in my career, I will be searching for this intellect where I can learn from. It's not got anything to do with age, anything to do with years of experience, and absolutely nothing to do with designation. Okay, so this was my first thought, which I thought I should share with you, okay, and then get into my planned tirade, if you can bear with me. And in between, if you feel anything where you want to challenge or question, you can definitely raise hand, okay. I don't want it to be totally one-way monologue. If you have anything, you can always ask. Okay. I had two sections to this. Okay. One is you can, listen to me. Okay. and I'll go the first profession of the yoga guru which we mentioned in the earlier part of the morning, okay, which will be a speech. Or I had something on entrepreneurship, okay, and we can see how we'll pace it across, okay. What is interesting is you look forward to being somewhere, you know, where maybe, you know, we all have reached, right? And I want to get back there. And this is the cycle of life, okay? When I was there, what I thought that anybody coming here would share is something which I would prepare, in all honesty. And that is what my predecessor did. And it is so much matching that, you know, that I had to say that, okay. And I was trying to figure out what is it, because the consulting mind goes on, you know, asking. And I figured out it is 3-4 years difference, and maybe we fought the same battle, okay? And I'll tell you some of my battles, and it will be a little bit more funnier, because I just told you that I'm more monkeyer than you, right? What I'm telling here is not preaching, so there is no you and me in this, okay? This is something which I try every day to do, and it's a suggestion that if you feel you resonate with this, maybe it will appeal to you, go with it. If not, throw it away. The quicker you throw it away, you're making a decision, let me tell you. And it's okay. And the first thing that I tell for myself, and when I think of myself in that seat, is that whatever I'll do, I should not forget values. That's my first and most important thing. If I don't have values, however big I become, it will not look good. However small impact job I do, it will not feel good. And you know what? The best definition of value is not in a book. It is in yourself, in your own conscience. You exactly know when you do a thing, whether it is right or wrong. Each one of us know. Do you agree? Think of all the places where you knew that this is something which I am doing, but you know what, it's not okay. And still we did. Bear with me, this is something which real life, transactional psychology, which each one of us for next 30 seconds, let's think of it. Anything that we did in a chalta hai mode, where we knew that something we are doing is not correct actually. And now think, suppose it was done 3 years back, 4 years back, 5 years back, whatever time in your life. And think for a moment, whatever you got out of it, does it matter now? Does it matter today? Think of a school note or, you know, a notebook of a particular semester which you did not share with your friend, or using your jugaad, you took it from somebody. Does your engineering grade matter today? Believe it or not, from here on, at any juncture of your life, whether personal or professional, anywhere where your heart is knocking and saying that something is wrong, this is not correct, I am getting compromised on my value system. Believe it or not, 3 years from that, 5 years from that or 10 years from that, it will not matter. It will not matter at all. So keep your values clean. And whenever a dilemma comes between mind and heart, human race progressed because of mind, but has survived because of heart. Don't let that go. Let heart rule. Are you all with me on this? Cool. I think that if I compare myself with the audience here, we all have more or less, you all have figured out more than what I figured out at your age. So if I start telling you that plan your career like this, plan your career like that, I feel that I am talking to a more capable person and trying to tell him what to do. I honestly believe that each one of us in this room has more or less got some thought cleared in their mind what I want to do. And those of us who feel and even tell our friends that no, I think I'm not clear, kuch bhi hoga, chalega, actually wo sab chalega upar hai, andar mein wo soch raha hai. Everybody is figured out or figuring out, right? While you do this, and I'm sure like my predecessor spoke great things about being hard working, having a vision, breaking tasks into small segments and then, you know, going after it and all that. All these are in management books. And initially itself I understood that all of you know so much that you would have figured it out. But when you are in this whole progress of going ahead with your career from here on, I want to just leave you with a thought that what do you think should be the priority? Okay? If it were our parents, you know, say that you work hard, you have to read, forget about eating and, you know, sleeping and all. Bakadhana Swan, I mean, there is some Sanskrit verse on that also, right? My thought to you is that from here on, whatever you do, get the right balance on. And the first priority should be your own health. Today, health and fitness is not only for the Olympic athletes, but for each one of us. If we think that collectively we need to contribute more to the country and more to the planet, you have to be healthy. And we are aware of all the vices we have, right? Balance your vices. As I said, I'll not be sermoning that do this, don't do that and all that. Because what all I have done, maybe you all have not tried. So balance it. And first priority should be health. And one of the things which in last 20 years, in a high growth rate economy, what 90 to 95% of people or workforce have somewhere compromised is health. And the second one is family time. It is very interesting to see that our parents were always there when we were growing up. You know, evening 6, they used to return. Okay? Many say it was inefficient economy. But look at it. When you travel across globe to the most affluent of countries, I've been lucky that, you know, that I've gone, I have had friends everywhere. I today have friends. I go and though I would be having a hotel room, I prefer going and staying with them. Because that actually gives us to know more about the culture, more about the people. The family values and the time to family is such a big important thing. You know what? In NASCOM, I can speak this. It is okay. But nobody comes to a B school and speaks about this. I feel that you all are more intelligent, more evolved. At the beginning itself, you should have your priorities set. And we all should try that the priorities, one, health, second, family, and third, career. If your first two is not in place, putting third one in place is like a humongous task. Okay? The next was hunger for learning, and that's something which is true for all of us. If the day I lose my hunger for learning, my distinction of being human being is lost. And as you grow higher, it is so easy to get lost in self-devised delusions and theories and zone of comfort. And when 20 people are agreeing to everything you say, oh my God, you know what? That's the toughest seat. You can flip. You can say that, wow, see, 20 people are telling yes. In a board meeting, everybody said yes to what I said. That is the most unsatisfied meeting for me. I get back from that meeting, and whole night I'm thinking that something was wrong. And we get into that theory and somehow curb our hunger for thinking. Think for yourself. Each one of us thinks that we have come to a B school. Every time we thought it is a passport to life. 10th exam, very important. Board exams. Ek bar board ho jaye na, achha, fir sab theek ho jayega. Passport to life. Board ho gaya, yaar, career, plus two, important. Beta, plus two dekh le, baki sab set hai. You did your plus two. With whatever, you know, that is the place where you deviate the most in your, you know, because your teenage and your age and everything. So that is the most deviation point. Okay? But somehow we did that. Agar kharab bhi hua to entrance ka dwar hai. We do something. Yaar ek entrance crack ho jaye, passport to life. Crack bhi ho gaya. And you get into this some good engineering colleges, medical colleges, you know, commerce college, arts college, science college, and then you feel this is passport to life. Oh my God, that's not. You have to do an MBA also on top of it. And once you get into a B school, you feel that, yo, I am a CEO material now. And that you are a CEO material means definitely you have a passport to life. But oh my God, you saw your seniors in the placement week. Where's the passport to life? You know what, this passport to life is a chase. Not because I'm from JP Morgan Chase, but it is a chase. And you go on chasing, and this passport to life never comes. But if your hunger for learning is there, and if you have been able to keep the child alive, that's the only thing which will keep us alive, survive, and we will be better off as a human being. Another interesting thing, and which I don't know if it has changed now because you all are more intelligent, right? How many of you remember whatever was taught in first semester or first trimester? My B school at trimester. Okay. You don't have to raise your hand. I know your profs are sitting here. One of the things that we say that, and I'm talking a little bit from engineering bias, but you know, whatever is taught in first semester, right? It's like Vegas. Whatever happens in Vegas stays in Vegas. But you know what? We call ourselves that we are in a professional. Do you call yourself you are into a professional course now? Yes. Thankfully, none of us are doctors. If I would have forgotten what I was taught in the first year as a doctor, okay, saying that, sorry, you've come to me for a lungs disease, very good. But you know what? Lungs was taught in first year. You have heart problem, come to me. So it's not only hunger for knowledge or hunger for learning, but also the hunger to say that when I have the hunger and I satiate it in the right way, okay, and not take anything lightly. I mean, your first semester or first, while he was putting this on, I was just saying that will my pictures come okay? Because all right, thank you, thanks. So, when we are talking of a professional course, you can't afford to forget anything which is taught at any point of time. If you want to be in this profession, it's different if that after this you want to do a stand-up comedy or you want to play guitar, then please don't forget what you learned in the first exercise. When you do your finger exercise in guitar, don't forget that. And this goes on. Okay, and that's something which is important. How many of you are having work experience of more than 6 years? Anybody in the audience? More than 4 years? Sir. Front rows absolved. More than 4 years? More than 3 years? Okay, cool. Thanks. Got it. If anyone who has headed even a small unit and has come to a B school can vouch, you can't forget any paper in first trimester, second trimester, or sixth trimester, whichever. And that will haunt you when you go there. HR, oh my God, that's a girly thing. Oh my God, finance, mere se nahi hota. Sir, aap finance mein specialization karo ya na karo, wo aapko nahi chhodta agar aap MBA bante ho. Marketing, man, I am a finance dude. I can't go around. Dude, I can't go around into the shops on the field, okay, and some, you know, what should I say, the more beautiful sex saying that, oh my God, what happens to my makeup? I'll get sunburnt. Good. Ma'am and sirs, whether you want to do finance specialization or marketing specialization, you have to know the other part of it. Think of it, someday you become a CEO and you say that, you know what, I've forgotten HR, I did not learn, and it was 22 years back, and that was what? That was girly thing, man. I'll hire a good HR manager. And you become slave to the HR manager because whatever he says, you Google up and try to counter, but it's not as good as you've done. So hunger for knowledge is not only learning and forgetting, it is learning and retaining. And the challenges will be there. Okay? Sometimes things happen to you, sometimes you think, you know, make things happen. Enjoy both. Enjoy both. Okay? If you hear about me, you know, it's quite a topsy-turvy kind of a career. I think even my being born, there was some big topsy-turvy in that. I was born in Arunachal Pradesh. I don't know if all of you know of that, but it's one state and it was in news recently. So being born in Arunachal Pradesh, some 40 years back, is different from what you are seeing today in the news bite. Newspaper used to reach 3 days late. You understand what do I mean? 1st September's newspaper used to reach on 4th September. Okay? Now it is very easy to say we are part of India and all the stuff, right? We used to sit on the bed with All India Radio in the middle, okay, that All India Radio would beam in a particular wavelength, and in a day that would be beamed twice, and that was our connectivity to India. Thankfully, Chinese didn't have radio then. Okay, and the problem is that when I go to China and apply for visa, since my passport says I'm born in Arunachal Pradesh, they don't give me visa. They give me a permit saying that I'm Chinese. Okay, so see, I mean, like, you can have topsy-turvy of any type, right? I mean, in life. I was lining up to becoming a fighter pilot in Navy. Met with an accident, came back. Somebody said, Fauji ka dimag ghutna mein hota hai. So I had to prove that ghutna is maybe wire, okay? And I studied geology, then I went on to, you know, being, and this is all because of some good blessings and good friends, good wishes, right? I was topper in IIT Roorkee's master's entrance, and I was doing M.Tech in remote sensing and earth satellites. Left that, took a sales job where I used to go to each house, and people used to leave their dogs on me. They would slam the door on me. I was selling computer products, computer education, okay? And where at the age of 21, 22, when you go, okay, and you are telling a parent whose daughter is 24 years to come and study that computer course, it's a very different sales experience. If you are smart and they find that, oh, he's smart, how much you're earning and all, it can go in another direction. If they feel that you're no good, then they say that, why are you here? You're trying to be smart. You study in the same college as my daughter, I know. So I've seen that. And from there, to getting into Six Sigma, having a startup of my own, and then moving into consulting and all that, it's been all topsy-turvy. But you know what? Each and every day I've learned. Each and every day I have learned from peers, from subordinates, from seniors, more from subordinates. They're fantastic. Many a times I feel that, God, you have been so kind. Actually, I should have been not the boss, but they. And that's the fun of, you know, enjoying the journey. And as Mr. Birabar spoke, Birabar, that enjoy the journey. See, next 20 years will fly. But if you have not enjoyed the journey, you have not taken vacation, you've not gone with people whom you love, okay, to places which you felt as a child you want to go. Why? Because you're saving money. Or you're thinking of a bad day. Why? Because you think that today's job is a khairat. Tomorrow I don't know. Don't worry. You have come so far, you'll get so far. So, enjoy the journey. And when I was there, most of us, 98% of us wanted jobs. But what I find now great is that many of you want to create jobs. How many of you want to create jobs? Look at that. Sir, look at that. Can we have a clap for yourself? Now I will ask the front row colleagues of mine, when we were studying, how many hands went up like that? None. So you see, you have already progressed. Day in, day out, you know, I feel that each one of us, as we grow into this next generation, it is fantastic. You humble me, you surprise me, and you earn so much of respect from me for thinking the way you think, for making me believe that human race is on evolution. One of the things which I believe, which in our education setup we don't train, is how to have constructive criticism. Do you have peer-to-peer criticism courses? In communication, do you have a section which says that how to criticize your peer? See, critic and criticizing is different. You all should object to criticizing. But critiquing is a great art and which we miss. If you ask me today in corporate India, something which we miss, which is not taught in B school, is how do we have constructive critiquing and tolerance to constructive critiquing. The moment I'm in a position of power, we come to a state that nobody can critique. How dare you object my point? Oh my God, then why did I hire you? I could have hired my clones. So this is one skill set if you can bring up in your next few years of how to have constructive critiquing, and when a critiquing is being done to you, how to tolerate. Another thing, how many of you want to be leaders? Fantastic, thank you. How many of you want to be led? Then how will the companies work? How will the sectors work? This art of being led is another thing which we need to develop in our next few years. And it is all transactional. And so you will see that there is something, some theory which is, I don't know if you're taught here, is situational leadership. So when situational leadership is taught, I urge all of you to think in the direction, and it's my request, that can I be led? If these two people are comparing, then in this work, I have to be led by them. Tomorrow, I'm doing a project on FinTech. They feel that I have more exposure of that. They should be ready to be led by me. And that's important. And I'm not going into ego and all that because we read a lot of moral science. And many times we talk about problems. It is the onus of anybody who is going with what are the problems. It's the onus and responsibility to go with few suggestions and solutions. Might work, might not work, but at least you have spent some thought on that. And that is a key success mantra for most of the people I've seen in corporate life. You can critique, you can have a problem, you can tell about the problem, but few alternatives when you give, 9 out of 10 times, your bosses have not thought of that alternatives. That's a great, great help. And the last thought which I'm leaving you all with is that celebrate the success of others. We are in such a competitive world, and then, you know, as you go out from the B school, like you see B school, one of the biggest thing that is coming up is your placement week. And day zero, day one, all these terms are competitive inductions which have happened. And if you take a whole statistics of last 10 years, from the top B school to the 100th one, this day zero, day one, this philosophy, and see that what are the parameters where they've reached, there is no correlation. But you know, but we are competitive. Class mein first aaya kya? Okay, good. Grade point kitna aaya kya? And as you go to the next phase of your life, you will be introduced to something called as a bell curve. Some companies are going away from there, but there will be relative ranking, there will be relative rating, and all the stuff. We are also blessed with so much of population in the country that for everything we are very competitive. My request to all of you, and this is to me also, I always remind myself, is that we need to know how to celebrate the success of others. But when you celebrate the success of others, give your best before that. The competition should be healthy, fair, and of the highest level. The person winning should be satisfied of the victory which that person is getting. And after the game is over, we should know how to hug each other. The biggest strength is for the winner and loser to be together in the company. Nobody says that the loser has to leave the company. That was one round, okay? And that's one of the most important thing. And when we are looking at it from a contextual thing of a human race, see that every day, what are you leaving for your next generation? What are you leaving for your progeny? Most of the times we are thinking that, what can I get for myself? Why do I want this career? I want this. I want a Ferrari. See, the ride from Honda City to Ferrari, that chase does not stop. I have not heard anybody saying that, you know what, I want to give 100 Ferraris to people before I die. Not charity. Without charity also, you can leave a lot of legacy. Okay? And there are two traps. In any, like in finance market, the traps are anger, greed and fear. In success, the thing which I follow is that whenever you're successful, and some of you are, each one of us are, we are all here because so many things worked okay. If polio vaccine was not given to me, I don't know where I would have been. I was born in Arunachal after all. In success, chase for humility. Run behind humility. In failure, stay with fortitude. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Now the house is open for questions.
Hello, sir.
Hey, hi. Hi.
Hello. Sir, I'm Arjun from Senior Operation Batch. So, as you have been a quality professional, I would like to know your take on Juran's continual improvement and why are we still stuck in Bob Galvin's 3.4 parts per million? Because while we can be better than that, why are we still stuck with that probability?
Fantastic. See, these are all two houses of quality, right? And if, I mean, the books which we have read and all that, there is this first thing of progress that should it be invention or innovation? And the thing which you are mentioning is more in the innovation direction, right? Which is quality improvement, process improvement. Right. So we had a Japanese model and a US model. And the Japanese model worked very well in US. So many of the US people went and said that, wow, let's make a book of it. Okay. When you go and see on the ground, there are few companies who have been successfully able to do it right, whether it is Toyota or GE or Motorola. When a theory is done, it's not that it has to be applicable to all. Two, when you're talking of Six Sigma, it's a construct. 3.14, there is a statistical reason why it is 3.14. And that statistical reason has put it 3.14. Nobody says that you have to get stuck there. So what they did intuitively and intelligently by some younger people who were more human, so they said that we will now not define it as Six Sigma, we'll get into 12 Sigma, we'll get into 24 Sigma, and there's a reason why I'm telling this, because that is how the progression happens. And that is possible. So it does not matter 3.14 or not, but the chase or the aspiration to perfection has moved from Six Sigma to beyond. So to your point, we are already in that path. Okay? So it's like telling that why the meter thing which is there in the Greek museum is considered as 1 meter. That's the standard. But have we now been able to measure planets? Yes. We have changed the measurement to light years. So 3.14 does not go anywhere. Yes, from 6 sigma we have moved to 12 sigma.
Okay, good morning, sir.
Good morning. There's a lady and there's a gentleman there. Yes, lady, please.
Sir, my name is Jyoti Jain. I'm from IB Finance. Sir, as you said, don't compromise health and family time. On the other side, we have seen employees who work for more than 10 to 12 hours in a day to achieve organization goal. So in what way, according to you, should an individual manage his time?
Yeah, good question. Good question. See, each decision is an individual decision, right? It is not about whether you're working 12 hours, 14 hours, 18 hours, 20 hours. I am not canvassing anything, nor am I canvassing that work for 1 hour. What I'm trying to tell is that you have this many hours and divide it with first priority to your health, second to family, and then to career. Even the government believes, I think they increase the maternity leave from 3 months to 6 months, right? So they have understood that mothers have started neglecting kids and that needs to be taken care of. But what I'm trying to tell here is that one of the things in office also I see many times is that hours are put in for the sake of hours. It's not the long hours which is required. And most of the companies are now having paradigm shift. So you will see this is the reality which is evolving, is that we need to balance it out. And my priority still stays like health, family, and then career.
Good morning, sir.
Yes, sir.
Sir, you actually talked about intellect and relevant experience. And then you actually talked about the art of being led. So, sir, my question is it the duty of the guy with relevant experience to actually lead the guy with intellect, to seek for him, and then lead the guy with intellect? And then in the end, how will the guy with the intellect know when to take up the mantle and lead?
Fantastic question. I thought that, you know, people who are not used to this usage would have got a little confused with so many of intellect usage. But you're right. You're right. The humility to learn from somebody who is 10, 15 years younger to you, 10 years younger to you, 5 years younger to you, maybe your peer, maybe your senior, that is something which will, once you learn, then that becomes, whatever you have learned becomes a knowledge for you. And once you practice it, it becomes relevant experience for you. So quicker and faster you do that, your intellect curve, which I told in the XY axis, that is increasing. Nobody is going to stop it. And if you grow it in many dimensions, even the person from you whom you learned, in due course of time, is ready to be led by you. And being led and leading, both are great skill sets. In silo, thank you. Yep.
Good morning, sir. I am Akshay Bakliwal from Senior Operation Batch. So my question is to you that what specific skill sets must be required to make a career in analytics? Because as an operation, we are responsible for the reducing the cost. And then too, it will be going to happen in through analytics in the near future.
Okay. I will expand it to the initial questions also, okay? And this is also another great skill set that we need to develop in ourselves. Is how to ask questions and how to ask right questions. Before even qualifying into right or wrong, we should know how to ask questions. Asking question is the first step of any analytics, scientific progression, process improvement, whatever you're talking of, even consulting. Actually, the joke which Dr. Padi, the story which he told, actually it is not about director, it was about consultants. And incidentally, I'm a consultant and a director also, so it holds twice for me. But everything starts with a question. world's best invention started with a question. The power of question is the biggest thing. Analytics follows on that. So if you're asking me what is the first skill set, hone up your skills of asking questions. If you see a pattern, why this pattern is there? How this pattern is evolving? Why is there an outlier? Why things are falling into place? Why two things are moving in similar way? And at the same time, have the common sense of not correlating sunrise with something else. You know that story, right? So, common sense, biggest tool, first skill set, asking question. Let me tell you, if you don't know numbers, you don't love numbers, you don't love maths, you don't love statistics, you would not have asked me this question. I hope I answered your question. Those are the skill sets. Thanks.
Thank you, sir. So the lesson you taught, the importance of value and not to compromise on it, then the importance to accomplish your target and not to apply the attitude of chalta hai, and last, the balance between health, work life, and family time with having the hunger of learning and knowledge has inspired us.
May I now request Dr. Suresh Chandrapadi, Director, BIIB, to present a memento to our guest of honor.